गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। इज माई वॉइस इज ऑडिबल? आर यू एबल टू सी द स्क्रीन? Mark your attendance using three parameters. Okay, so once again, good morning all. So this is the video lecture on design and analysis of algorithms. We are currently discussing with module 3 greedy technique. So today we shall go with a new concept. So what is a new concept we are going to see? It is an optimal tree problem. So this is the new topic what we are going to discuss, apart from spanning tree or shortest path, whatever we have discussed. So from that, it is the new one what you are going to consider. Okay, so very, very important concepts are these, because you will compulsory you will be getting questions from all these algorithms, including Prim's, Pruskal, Dijkstra, Softman tree, everything. You will be getting the questions for the exam. Okay, so in that, today we shall see optimal tree problem. In that, we are going to discuss Huffman trees and Huffman code. So two things are there. One is Huffman tree, the other one is Huffman code. Okay, so it's very easy and simple concept. So compared to Prim's, Pruskal and Dijkstra's, Huffman tree and code are very, very easy to understand. So before going, first you see optimal tree problem. So in the background, so we shall see what's the problem and why you are going for this particular optimal tree problem. Okay, so suppose we have to encode the text. The encode means you are converting from one format to another format. So that's when we call it as word encode. So encode is means you are converting the text from one format to another format. So that we call it as encoding. So encoding the text that comprises what? Text means it comprises of characters from some n character alphabet. So I will tell you how to encode the text. Okay, so that comprises of characters from some n character alphabet. Okay, so encode by assigning to each of the text characters some sequence of bits called the code word. So there are two types of encoding. One is fixed length encoding, the other one is variable length encoding. So what's the meaning of encoding? Converting a character by some other character. Okay, so if it is A, you are changing it to D. Okay, if it is B, you are changing it to E. So by that comprises of what? So you are encoding the text that comprises of characters from some n character alphabet. So I will tell what is this n character alphabet. Keep in your mind, if I am replacing A with D, so how many characters are being changed? So I am replacing A with D. What is the distance of A and D? Yes, can you tell? I am changing A by D. Okay, so what is the distance? How many characters you have changed? So A is the first character, B is the second character. So C is the third character, D is the fourth character. You are changing, so that is fourth character, you are changing it by three. So three character alphabet you are changing. Understanding? So we are encoding the text. Okay, text consists of what? Characters. So here the A has been replaced with D by some three character alphabet. Okay, so three num n is the number. So three character alphabet means if A is there, D will come. If B is there, E will come. If C is there, F will come. Okay, so that we call it as a so encode by assigning to each of the text characters some sequence of bits called code word. There are two types of encoding. One is fixed length encoding. The other one is variable length encoding. So there are two types that we shall see here. So fixed length encoding. So under fixed length, this method assigns to each character a bit string of same length m. So as I told, if you take fixed length means, I will tell n is equal to 3. So if A is there, it is fixed to 3 characters. If n is equal to 3, so it will be applicable for all the characters. If A, B, C, D is there, you will be getting it as E, F, G, H, something. Okay, so just shift it, shift A by 3 characters, B by 3 characters, C by 3 characters, D by 3 characters. So that one we call it as fixed length encoding. Okay, so fixed length encoding or coding. Okay, so assigns to each character a bit string of same length m. And see what is the drawback you are having. So we shall see drawback, how to overcome the drawback. So assigning shorter code words to more frequent characters and longer code words to less character. So assign shorter code words to more frequent characters and longer code word to less frequent characters. So this is the problem what we get using fixed length encoding. Now you come for variable. Okay. So understand if the text is A, B, C, D, okay, and n value is equal to 3, okay. So tell what is the encoded text. Yes, can you answer? I'm giving here, so A, B, C, D, this is the text I'm giving. And with n is equal to 3. Okay, so what is the encoded text using fixed length coding? So kindly tell me here. I have taken the text as ABCD with n is equal to 3. Okay, so can you tell what is the encoded text? So encoding means replacing the character by some other characters. So by which character? By using the length of 3, you are replacing A by some characters. A, B, C, D. Okay. So A, B, C, D. So A replace it by 3 characters. So which is the third character of after A you will get? After A, B, C, D. So A is replaced by D here. B. B after 3, which is the third letter after B? C, D, E. So B becomes E. So come for C. So C, replace it by 3 characters. D, E, F. So final answer will be D, E, F, G. Okay. So this is fixed length coding. So what you have written for A, B, C, D, you have for each character, the length becomes 3 only. So you will be writing it as D, E, F, G. Okay, so D, F, G, it's the fixed length. So A is also moved by 3 characters, B is also moved by 3 characters, C also by 3 characters, and D by 3 characters. So that is called as a fixed length. So now you come for the next topic, that is variable length coding. So assign code words of different lengths to different characters. Understanding? So A is, for A, I'm giving some number. For B, I will be giving some number. For C, I will be giving some number. So that we call it as variable length encoding. So prefix codes are used. Here, no code word is a prefix of code word of another character. So if I given A by A, I am replacing by M, no other characters can have the value M. Okay, so if I am replacing B by Z, so no other character will be having the value Z. Understood? Are you understanding? Am I audible? Am I audible? Okay. So understand, in variable length coding, so you can assign any character to any other. Not like a fixed length. For A, you will be having D only. So you can have any other character. For B, you can have for A, B, C, D. For A, you can assign Z. For B, you can assign A also. So that is the concept what you are having. Understanding? So that is called as a variable length coding. We can simply scan a bit string until we get the first group of bits, that is a code word for some character. So if you want to create a binary prefix code for some alphabet, it is natural to associate the alphabet characters with leaves of the binary tree in which all the left edges are labeled by 0 and all the right edges are labeled by 1. So many trees that can be constructed for a given alphabet. So for more frequency of character occurrences, construction of the tree. So construction of such tree will be invented by David Uffman. So how are you going to construct shorter bit strings to high frequency character? Longer ones to low frequency character can be done by greedy algorithm invented by David Uffman. I will tell you what this is going to do in this concept, that is Uffman trees and codes. Okay, so Uffman algorithm. So understand these two steps. So it will be very easy to construct. Okay. So because there will be a compulsory problem you will be having on this Uffman trees and codes. So go through this algorithm. So it helps to solve your problem. So Uffman algorithm, step one. So initialize N. N means number. Number of one node trees and label them with characters of the alphabet. Okay. So you have to go through one node trees and label them with the characters of the alphabet. Okay, record the frequency of each character in its tree's row to indicate the tree weight. So come for step two. Repeat that following operation until single tree is followed. Find, this is the very, very important. So go through this. This is very, very important concept. Okay, so find a true two trees with the smallest weight. Okay, so first step is find the two trees with the smallest weight, make them the left and right subtree of the new tree and record the sum of their weights in the root of the new tree as its weight. So first you have to find two trees with the smallest weight. Okay, so keep on doing until a single tree is obtained. Okay, so finally you should get a tree. Okay, so for that, find the two trees with the smallest weight, make them left and right subtree of the new tree and record the sum of the weights. The tree constructed by above algorithm is called as a Uffman tree. It defines in the manner described Uffman code. Okay, so if you are recording like this, so one node trees will be there, label them with characters, record the frequency of each character to indicate the tree's weight. Okay, first you have to go with, they will give you a statement. So in that, which are the characters are there and how many times it is repeated in that word. So suppose I take Uffman. So F is repeated two times, H is repeated once, U is repeated once, M, N. So everything is repeated once. So that is the record the frequency of each character. Next, Find the two trees with the smallest weight, make them left and right subtree of the new tree and record the sum. So tree which you have constructed is called Huffman tree, and the code what you get is the Huffman code. So this is the example I will be taking. So understand carefully, this is a very, very important thing. So there are four characters. How many characters are there? A, B, C, D, hyphen. Okay, so frequency they have given. This is frequency is nothing but number of occurrences. Okay, so number of occurrences they have given. Now you have to construct the tree. Okay, so sort the things in ascending order. So when you sort the things in ascending order, so which one will be the, how will be the tree? So first sort the things in ascending order. So when you sort, which is the first one you'll be having? 0.1. 0.1 is nothing but 0.10. 0.10 is the thing. So 0.1 we have taken. Next one is 0.15. So we have taken 0.15 here. C 0.2, D 0.2, and finally A 0.35. Okay. So first you have to write this. So now consider the two nodes of lesser weight. So which are the two nodes of lesser weight? Yes, which are the two nodes of lesser weight? So there are five nodes, A, B, C, D, hyphen. Okay, so in that, which are the nodes of lesser weight? So here you have to see, okay, the frequencies are given of each character. Which are the characters we are having? A, B, C, D, and hyphen. So after that, find the two trees with smallest weight. So which are the smallest weight you are having? 0.1, 0.15. Take that 0.1 and 0.15. 0.1, you make it left, and 0.15 you make it right subtree. So understand here. So two trees with smallest weight, make them the left and right subtree of the new tree. This is the new tree we have constructed, P and minus. So B is having 0.1, C minus is having 0.15. When you add both, what is the new value you are getting? 0.1 plus 0.15 is equal to 0.25. Okay, so this one we have taken 0.25. So now after that, so that will come here. So here we have taken 0.1, 0.15, part is been on the left side. Okay, so because see the values here, 0.1, 0.15 is finished. So what is the next one after 0.1, 0.15? Which are the next two? 0.2 and 0.2, both of C and D. So take that 0.2 and 0.2 of C and D. So that one you make it right subtree. So 0.2, 0.2 will go to 0.4, C and D with A remaining same. So now you come for this part is already, it is the previous part, you are having it here. So now you make the things, okay? So now A is there. So where you place this A? That comes the concept. So this is one tree. So now you can, now what is the value you are having? 0.35. So where the 0.35 you can add? So if you are marking 0.35, you can, here we can see that 0.2, 0.2 has been noted with C and D here. So 0.25 is, so C and D part, it comes here. So 0.25, B and hyphen, for that you have added 0.35. So you, the condition what you are having to, whether to join A or B, whether you have to add it to A or you have to add it to this part or you have to add it to this part. So as you have 0.35, so 0.35 is greater than which one? So it is greater than 0.2, greater than 0.2, which is the nearest one to 0.35? So 0.25 is the nearest one to 0.35. ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಫೋರ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಟೂ ಫೈವ್. ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್? ಸೊ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಟೂ ಫೈವ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಆ್ಯಡಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಫೈವ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗಿವ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಫೈವ್ ಎಸ್ ಅ ರೈಟ್ ಸೈಡ್. ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಟೂ ಫೈವ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಫೈವ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನೌ ಯು ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟ್ ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಟ್ರೀ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆಡ್ ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಟ್ರೀ, ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಜಾಯ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಟ್ರೀ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್, ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಫೈವ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ 1.0. Understood. So this is the simply the we have given 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. Understood? So are you understood this particular concept? So to for which value you have added, I'm telling. So just you have whether to add 0.35 to 0.25 or 0.35 to 0.4. So which is the nearest one you are having? I am going to add it to 0.25. So 0.25 kinta 0.35 kinta 0.25 kadme. So you will be making, you will add 0.25 and 0.35. Don't go for 0.4 because the value what you are going to get 0.35 with 4, it will take you to 0.75. Okay. Okay, so that's why 0.25 has been added with 0.35 has been added with 0.25 and we have made it with 0.6. So this is the Huffman code what you are going to see. So resulting Huffman codes. Okay, so resulting code words are as follows. So dad is encoded as dad. So where is D? So here is the D word. So what is the D word and their frequencies are given here. This is the final code words what you are having. So frequency A is having 0.35, B 0.1, C 0.2, D 0.2, hyphen 0.15. So come for code word of A. So code word of A, it is from root node. What is the code you are having? 1 1. So 11 is the code word for A. Come for B. Where is B? Here. So from root node 100. Code word is 100. Come for C. So C is 00. C comes under 00. D 01. Code word is 01. For hyphen. So where is the hyphen? Here. 101. So it is for 101. So when you encode D A D, dad is encoded as. Okay, so dad, so what you take the values for dad, so it is encoded as this particular thing. Okay, so it is the encrypted format what we give. So just you can take it. So D is represented as 01, A is represented as 11, and again D is represented as 01. So dad, word dad can be represented as 01 11 01. So that is the encoded format. This is the Huffman code. So come for the analysis part. So average number of bits per symbol in this code. So average number you have to take. So average number, how much you are having? A, B, C, D, hyphen. Okay. So average number of codes for A. So average number of for A, how many characters are there? 1 is 1, 2 digits. So 2*0.35. So I will be giving average number of bits you take. So A is having how many bits? 2 bits. So 2*3.15. Then B is having how many bits? 3 bits. So 3*. So it is 3*0.1. Next, C is having how many bits? 2 bits. So you will be giving it as 2*0.2. Now you come for the D. D is having 2*0.2 and finally 3*0.15. So finally value is 2.25. So come for the compression ratio. How the values are compressed? So that you have to take it. So how many compression ratio? The characters are 3. So 3 characters are there. So 3 minus 2.25 divided by 3 star 100. So that will give you, what is this 3? The number of characters what we have here, we call it as 3 here. So 3 minus average number of bits divided by number of characters star 100. That will give you the compression ratio. So our string is compressed by 25%. In other words, Hoffman's encoding of the above text will use 25% less memory than its fixed length encoding. So understanding, so Hoffman code will come under variable length encoding. Okay, so it and Hoffman coding will use 25% less memory than fixed length encoding. So understood up to here? So have you understood the analysis? Yes, reply in the chat box. So how we have taken the strings? It is number of bits we have taken. So A is having how many bits? 2. B is having 3. C is having 2. D is having 2. Hyphen is having 3. Okay. So the, so that's why you give 2 star 0.35, 3 star 0.1, 2 star 0.2, 2 star 0.2, 3 star 0.5. So that is the Hoffman coding. So how to write the code word for A? Where is A? Here. So what is the code? 1, 1. For B, 1, 0, 0. For C, 0, 0. For D, 0, 1. For E, it, so for hyphen, so it is 1, 0, 1. So that is the code values what we have written. So now you come for the homework part. So represent the text A, B, C, D, E. This is the homework part you will be having. Okay, so homework, represent, they will give you the string. So you have to represent the Hoffman code as well as Hoffman tree. So what is the, how many times, which are the characters you are having? A, B, C, D, E. So A is how many times? Can you tell the frequency of characters? So can you tell the frequency of characters? A is how many times, B is how many times, C, D, and E. So A is only once, B, B here 1, 2, next coming for C 1, 2, 3, so D 1, 2, 3, 4, and finally E 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So A is once, B is 2, C 3, D 4, E 5. So I have given the frequencies, sort according to that and keep on joining. Okay, so so when you join, which are the lowest frequency ones? A and B will take one part. Next, after that, C is different. E is, so then you add C, then you add D, then you add E. Okay, if you have same values, you can make the another tree. But here you are getting different nodes. So values are different. A1, B2, C3, D4, and D5. So that's why I'm telling you have to go with. So for AB, you add C. Next, you add D. Like that, you can do it. So consider this homework part. So homework part in the previous. So previous example, we have taken using the same Digistress, internals question will come. So Hoffman code, I will be asking the same question in your internals. Okay, so go through this, make this problem solve and take the marks in the internals. Okay, so this is up to Hoffman code. Okay, so I hope you all got understood the Hoffman code and trees. Understood? So in tomorrow, this particular video will be uploaded in YouTube channel. Kindly go through, understand, and learn the concepts. Kindly like, share, and subscribe for the channel to get the knowledge of the algorithms. Okay, so I hope you all understood. So ending this particular lecture. So thank you all. Stay home, stay safe.